Welcome everybody. It's Thursday the 21st of May 2020 and this is a Tilt webinar with Ceri Anwen James on interactive quizzing for distance learning. So there you've got the description of what we're going to be doing. It's going to be fun. We're going to be doing lots and lots of games. We've had Ceri give lots of presentations before to us, and the real strength is not only does she know about the games, but she knows how to manage things as well. So she shows how things are incorporated into a wider departmental assessment for learning strategy. So you're going to see lots of things here. I'm Helen Myers. I'm chair of the AOL London branch. That's the Association for London Languages, the Association for Language Learning, and we're the London branch. Also in the room is Jo Dale, independent languages consultant, and the person that we all know who's brought us all together for this, really. So lots of thanks to him. And also we like to thank Heike Philp, who's facilitated us with the support. She's given us loads of support on how to do these things. But the person you have come to see in particular is Ceri Anwen James, assistant head teacher. She's previously been the head of modern languages, and she oversees, I know she oversees loads of things. I've seen the work that she's been doing. Her official job is overseeing the school's digital learning, the one-to-one iPad scheme and digital competence framework, but she does loads more into her school as well. She's been collaborating with the Welsh Government on the writing of languages, literacy and communication for the new curriculum for Wales. So really, really very, we're delighted to have her with us. I say this every time, Association for Language Learning, please join if you're not a member. Please now write in the chat if you're a member and encourage others to join in. Or write, it'd be lovely to see people writing, yes, I'm going to join now. I'd like to belong to the AOL. So please do make use of the chat to support that. You know, we're all doing this as volunteers. Nobody's getting paid for anything, and it's because we really want to help people. But obviously it's great to be able to, through our membership fees, we're then contributing to the running of the association. As you know, you'll be able to get copies, you'll be able to see these videos if you go onto our webinar site. You'll be able to click, and you can also find about future webinars which are coming up. And Joe's brilliant. He is just bringing them all in, aren't you, Joe? So we've got Francois Stalder on May the 26th next week, who's going to be doing engaging students through video storytelling and critical thinking. So that's really, you know, quite a new topic for us. And then already we have loads of people who've signed up, and we can take many more on next Wednesday. So it's half term, but we know that that's actually a time when there are some NQTs getting, or people who are going to be NQTs next week, next year, getting a little bit anxious about things, wanting to ask questions. So do, if you know anybody, just let them know they're very welcome to come and listen to David Shanks there. And then the great Stephen Fawkes himself will be in this room on June the 4th to bring us up to date with things to do with languages. And it's going to be pretty much a question and answer session. So if you've got questions, get them ready and let us know what they are. So as always, we ask you to be aware of our etiquette. Above all, we are professional and kind. And we have to say that also that as at AOL London, we are happy, really happy to host everybody, and speakers and participants are responsible for what they say. So now, a Tilt webinar with Ceri Anwen James, interactive quizzing for distance learning. So I'm going to now stop my video, stop my audio, and pass over to Ceri now.
Thank you very much, Helen. Diolch yn fawr. It's great to be here. Thanks for the invitation from yourself and from Joe. We're all really sad that we didn't get to go to Dorking this year for the annual conference, but you know, the webinar series has been brilliant so far, really, really useful during the last few weeks of lockdown. So yeah, I'm going to share my screen with you now and talk you through my presentation and go through some different things. So the first thing is, where are we here? Cyflwyno. So the only thing is, for some of you, you may find very annoying, is the fact that the interface on my Google is all in Welsh. So when I show you screenshots, you won't maybe understand everything, but I'm sure you get the drift. So interactive quizzing, it's going to be an interactive night. So we're going to go through different things, and hopefully you'll be able to join in. So in the chat, if you go back, I've shared the slides with you, and maybe it would be handy for some of you. You can access all the activities by clicking on my gallery. Now, obviously, this is what people with MFL teachers have been doing in the lockdown, has been creating interactive classrooms. I couldn't quite cope with a classroom with all the primary colours and a bit moody of myself. So this is what I've gone for. So there are different links here, and obviously you'll be able to use then this after tonight as well. So this may be handy for some of you to go directly to some of the activities, but I am going to share the links during the presentation as well. There's a QR code there. So if you put this on your screen and then you can scan it with your phone or whatever, it'll take you to the presentation. So hopefully that's going to be useful for you there. Okay, so you're going to be watching me on one screen. It would be handy to have another screen as well. So have a phone or an iPad to hand. If you haven't got one, don't worry, but it'd probably be handy so you can take part in the interactivity of the whole thing. Okay, so so Helen has obviously said everything you need to know. So Broeden is a new school established in 2012. It's a Welsh medium. We've got a sixth form as well. And that's our Twitter handle for the school, Broeden. And then ITM, that is, underscore Broeden, is for the MFL department. ITM is MFL in Welsh. So we share all sorts of things, mainly to do with football and East Germany and whatever comes up, really. Yeah, so that's that. Okay, so we're talking about what makes a good quiz. Presumably, that's why you're here. You need to know before you start, it's not just about making a quiz to keep them entertained. You know, it's not, I suppose it is glorified entertainment, but the whole point is you need to know what you want to achieve out of it. And it's about the pedagogy, it's about the progress, about your pupils making more progress. And it's not about the tech, I would say. So you need to decide first what you want them to achieve, sort of linguistically, and then get the best tech really to fit that afterwards. Here are various things that you can put in a quiz. So words and translations, definitions, close exercises, grammar questions, questions about grammar, conjugation, you know, all these things. And then obviously lots of these quizzes are based on multiple choice. So you can have three completely wrong answers, which is not my favorite thing. Then you can, you know, have questions, multiple choice to do with tenses, adjectival endings. You can have near misses, spelling, accents. And hopefully in tonight's quizzes, some of them will have some sensible questions, hopefully for you to take away. Some of them have not got sensible questions, but it's just tonight about having some fun, really. Just understand the interactivity of the activities, how they work and how maybe you would be able to use them. I'm aware that everybody comes here this evening with different languages. I've created lots of things because all of my things for school are in Welsh. So that wasn't going to be useful for lots of you this evening. But so these are the type of things that you could do when you're planning quizzes, really, depending on what the focus is going to be in your class. So really, the key questions, what do you need them to develop or what do you need them to understand? And then you decide which tech is going to help you to achieve that aim. And you always have to remember that it's about the language learning. It's about the German. It's about the French. It's not about the tech. Okay, so we're going to start by looking at Mentimeter. So if you have another device, I'd like you to go to menti.com there, and then you'll need to put the code in, which is that 473600. Okay, and there are two activities there. So I'm going to leave this screen a second now and go over to Mentimeter so you can see it. So I'm going to present here, and there are lots of different options on Mentimeter. So once you're in, I hope you can all see this. Maybe Joe, Helen, it would be good to see, for somebody to say, yeah, it's working. Oh, right, it is working, because look at the screen, yay. So, this is something where you can sort of collect ideas from the pupils and it works live in class. I do use it quite a lot. I've also used it in our inset day with the primary cluster. That was really good. I'm collecting some ideas there about building the new curriculum. And we managed to do it with no problem, with 102 people contributed during that session. So as you can see, the most popular answers get bigger and bigger. So obviously there are lots of tired, happy and excited people in the room this evening, interested as well. And then, you know, it keeps on moving. It's good to look at. And one thing I have done with maybe your 8 or your 9 pupils, I've asked them to say, to choose some adjectives, and I've asked them to put 5 in. And obviously what happens is that the really common adjectives, the ones that you really don't want them to use all the time, are massive. So if you teach German, that's going to be gut and super and fantastisch. And what happens then is I say, if we then follow it up with a writing task, I say, okay, so all these big words, and I cross them off on the board, you're not allowed to use these during our writing work or in the oral presentation. These are the adjectives I want you to avoid. And that's really good, because they've obviously fed into the process and then they realize that everybody uses the same adjectives. And then it's one way of using it. So obviously people are still contributing. And it keeps on moving and it keeps on growing. And yeah, it's a good way of crowdsourcing ideas and crowdsourcing vocabulary, crowdsourcing verbs very often. And as I said, quite often I ask pupils to then avoid the big words and then to concentrate on some of the others. One thing is, the word has to be exactly the same for it to become bigger. So if you have fantastisch spelt in 3 different ways, it'll appear in 3 different ways on the cloud as well, because it obviously the program doesn't recognize the misspellings. Okay, so we're now going to go to the next slide.
Can I just check for people who've joined us recently, we'll keep on putting in the link to the Google presentation. Yeah. And if you go to slide 2, you've got everything ready for you with the links already prepared. It's been brilliantly prepared by you, Ceri. Thank you very much.
Great. Thank you, Helen. Right. And now I'm trying to work out, how do I get to the next slide on here? Right. I need to go off there. And then, it's very strange. Right. Okay. Right. So this is the next slide. So you can see that it does something different. So there's a question here, an open question for you, like all good questions. What do you hope to achieve tonight? Not falling asleep. And as you can see, they appear in boxes. So I was very sad, as Joe knows, at the demise of today's meet. So this is one of the things we use in school that's come instead of that. So this is an idea, and then it, as you have more and more contributions, they twirl and they move, and once again, that's a good idea of crowdsourcing some ideas. One of the things I did with this recently, and looking back, what a waste of time that was, with year 11, I recorded their oral, their mocks at Christmas. And their homework then by the new year, poor them, was to re-listen to their recording. And they had to then write themselves targets of what they needed to improve by the summer. And then we came back, they had to make themselves a list as homework as they were listening to their presentations, what they needed to revise, what they needed to improve. And then they came into class with the list. And what I asked them to do was to type up the answers here, so then we could share them then as a class of how they were going to improve by the summer, how they were going to revise, how they were going to develop different strategies. So you can use it obviously in the target language, but something like crowdsourcing ideas for mocks or, you know, to prepare for exams and things, that works really well, especially with the older pupils. Okay, so that's Mentimeter, so M-E-T-E-R, it's the American spelling. But you can do lots of different things there, crowdsourcing ideas and things, and I think that's a really good start. So what we're going to do now, this is the bit that Helen's been waiting for. The first question we're going to ask you tonight is, how could you use Mentimeter in your class? Okay, so we need you all to think. So now we're now going to do the digital equivalent of think, pair, share. Okay, so we need to think, how could you use this in class? We're going to put you into breakout rooms. So Helen is going to press a magic button and then you will appear in a breakout room with one other person. You're only going to be there for 2 minutes, which is not long. And obviously, the temptation to have a really long chat about where they are and how the weather is going to be massive. So if you just say hello, say your name and where you come from, and then go straight on to the question, which is, how could you use Mentimeter in your class? And then when we come back, we're going to share the ideas in the chat. Okay? So Helen.
Yes. So this is the first time we've done this.
Yay.
This is a bit of training as well. I should tell you what I am pressing. I'm pressing something which says breakout rooms now. I can assign 140 participants to one room, or I have up to, how many rooms can I have? I can have loads of rooms. So if there are 139, how many rooms would you like me to put them into?
In pairs, probably.
So in pairs would be, yeah, I think 50 might be the maximum that I can get. Let's see. I'm doing it in a very slow way. Click, 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 click. Yeah, 50 is the maximum.
There we
so
are.
I'm now going to put you into 50 different rooms. So there'll be 2 to 3 participants per room.
Excellent.
Just so that, you know, it can be a little bit of a distressing experience when you suddenly find yourself in this place. But know that in the end, you'll definitely be able to come back because we can just close the breakout rooms and it forces you to come back.
Yep. So when we'll be doing that in 2 minutes. And yeah, are you going to bring everybody back on mute then, Helen?
Yes, I think what we'll do is we will then just call you back. I'm not sure whether you'll be on mute or what will happen. We'll just have to be a bit relaxed about this. But okay, for you to control your mute and your video when you come back, that would be great. Okay?
Okay then. So off you go. 2 minutes. So how are you going to use Mentimeter in your classes?
Right. So I'm creating the rooms. I'm opening all the rooms. And there you are. So you should now have an invitation. And by the way, I could have forced you just to go, but I am just asking you to accept the invitation. Oh, it looks as if it's happening. As you all go. So yes, but not everyone. So some people, it may be that their breakout room 9 hasn't got anyone at the moment. Or it's got, at least they've all got at least 2 people, I think. I'm just making sure there isn't anybody on their own. Because thinking about it, there is a setting where you can just force everyone out as well.
So who are these people left on the screen here, Helen?
So they're people who haven't joined yet.
Okay. Right, are we timing this 2 minutes? I'll go and get my alarm.
So those of you who are still here, I hope you're okay. So Lucia, I'm going to assign you to, right, so somebody who hasn't been, so you must have had someone who's just joined. So Lucia, you've just joined. I'm going to quick, if we can assign you to, I don't know, I'm just putting you randomly in one, okay? Yeah, so people who are still here, I'd be quite interested to know why. It may be that they just joined and then are not at the keyboard.
Yeah,
that's so
because Joe's gone into a room with somebody, so
oh right, okay,
Joe's disappeared, hasn't he?
Yeah, I didn't necessarily am I meant to be somewhere? Perhaps I'm meant to be somewhere, I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh no, because you're, have you been invited to go anywhere?
I don't know, I don't think so, no.
And I hadn't seen this before, but people who then have not been assigned are people who've probably just joined us.
Okay, well, okay.
I think we'll live a bit longer because they're,
yeah,
people have only just got there, really. They'll be all right because it's only, it's the first time they've ever done this.
How are we doing for time? I haven't been going for long, have I? Right.
And don't worry, I mean, this is just brilliant. This is so good. And they love, I mean, that idea of you having, that's masterful, just having the links.
Somebody is saying, mine didn't work, as was laptop to everyone.
Right.
So that's on the screen.
And that can be to do
tricky with to do breakout rooms because I have people at home in the room with me.
Okay. So it could be that we say, you don't, in future, if you don't want to go to the breakout room, stay here and you can be with us. Shall I close all rooms now so they've got a minute?
Yeah, you can, So I think we should call them back in now.
Now they'll have a minute. So it says all breakout rooms will close in 58 seconds, 57 seconds, 56 seconds.
And then Becky Stevenson here is asking, please could you tell us how to organise breakout rooms for our own pupils?
Yeah, which I can do, I'll do that. In fact, I've made a little how-to video, which we can send out to people.
Hello, both.
Hello there. Oh, I recognise that voice anywhere. Where are you, Laura?
You okay?
I'm not on video,
but...
I can't see you. You're on a photo.
You don't want to see me.
Yeah, there'll be another screen. You've got to go right to the screen too.
No, I can see Laura is on.
I can see Laura. She's on top of my screen too.
Oh, is Adam there as well?
Yeah, well.
He is.
Hello, Adam.
Very good.
Okay, so if everybody wants to write. So we
they're not here yet. Right, they should all be back here now because all of the rooms have been closed. So if we just give them a moment to return before we start.
So, I'm not sure how that was. The first time I did it in a webinar, I was terrified and I ended up in a room with a woman in America. So, so do you want to write now in the chat about how you think you could use Mentimeter in your class or for one of your classes, or just write a few ideas we can share? Some people are just looking at me thinking, nah, I'm just sitting here.
And can you see the chat?
If anything.
Ceri, can you see the chat? So brainstorming.
Yeah, brilliant.
Cool.
Starters and plenaries, success criteria. Extended sentences for the 150 word. Oh God, there's so many ideas coming. So questions about a film, shares ideas, tenses, retrieval practice. Yeah, that's a good one. Somebody was asking, is there a profanity filter? So I'm not sure what somebody has seen.
Yeah, no, there is a profanity filter. So when you set up the presentation as the teacher, you can, on the word cloud one, for example, towards the bottom on the right hand side when you're setting it up, there's a profanity filter which is available in a number of different languages. So it's got, for example, French, Spanish, German and what have you, and yeah, also Icelandic and emoji as well, which is quite interesting.
With the profanity filter with the Mentimeter, yeah, there is one on that.
Yeah, but if the children use a symbol instead of a letter, then it will get through. And annoyingly, there isn't like a right click delete a word option. You'd have to just go onto another slide or just stop the presentation. So that's the one downside about Mentimeter, I think, but it is absolutely fabulous. One idea I shared in the breakout is the fact that you can use emojis. As I was posting the same emoji onto the Mentimeter, if you asked the students just to post emojis to gauge how they're feeling or maybe around a topic area, that's also a really nice way of using emojis as a vehicle for promoting language, I think, speaking. Mm-hmm.
Excellent. So thank everybody. Thank you very much for all your ideas. And what's really good here now is that people can go back and read through the chat and have a look at it there. So the next thing I'm going to talk about, if it's okay for us to move on, is
That's lovely. But can we ask everyone to turn off their webcams again, please, and mute their audio? That'd be lovely. Okay. Thank you.
The bouncer has spoken.
Mm-hmm. And can I say, I will publish the chat on our webpage. So you'll all have access to that because there were some superb ideas there. Thank you.
Yeah, and so many coming through so quickly. I couldn't read them. They were just flying up the screen. Okay, so we've discussed Mentimeter. So we're going to look at quizzes now. And when you land on quizzes on the holding page, this is what appeared for me because it gets to know you and what you do and what sort of quizzes you create. So they were recommendations for me when I logged in yesterday. So that's quite handy for some of you who would be able to maybe take ready-made quizzes. It's a really useful tool there. And then in quizzes, there are different types of questions. Multiple choice, where only one answer is going to be correct. A checkbox, where you can have more than one correct answer. Fill in the blank if you want to create a sort of close exercise. There's a poll, and there is also an open-ended question. I know one of my colleagues who teaches geography, he's done a mix of questions recently with an open-ended question where they write then extensively about a program they've been watching on climate change. So, you know, if you want to suggest that some of your other colleagues, that could be quite handy. So those are the different question options in quizzes. The feedback is quite handy. So I watch television. So this is the feedback on the quiz with year nine when I've been using it recently, well, not very recently because I haven't seen them, but I watch television. So anybody who teaches German knows that's a pain in the neck to get right. And then you can put different things with tenses. So number two is I have danced, where they have to then pick out the correct version of the past tense. So that was the feedback you get as a teacher is really handy for you to be able to assess where they're getting stuck. Then you have, you know, a summary of the different quizzes that you've been running. You can see then the percentage marks of accuracy for your classes. So that's also really handy from assessment for learning. You know then where you need to go back over the work. So I have created a quiz for this evening in quizzes. So you can set quizzes to be run live in class, or you can also run them as homework. You can set them up and close the quiz after a certain amount of time. So I want you to go to joinmyquiz.com, and that is the code. So that is a 5, then a 1 and an 89126. So I wasn't sure about the font, and I'm still not very sure about the font, and the numbers look a bit messy to me, so it's a bit late.
Just check, if we go to the link in your presentation, is that that's the one that you've prepared, isn't it?
So I think so, yes. But if you want to be safe, you go to join my quiz. Yes.
So it is working. The link you gave us is working. The
link is working, excellent. Yeah. Okie dokie. Fine. So if I go to... maybe you're going into the homework option. Do you want us to play it live to see what happens?
Yeah.
Or are people happy to play it? If we play it live, and we play it with the classic continue. Yeah, so this is the number for us to play live, joinmyquiz.com, and then I think that's a different game code. So you can set it as homework, which is really handy, and they can play it as many times. Ooh, and people are flying in. Excellent. Mm-hmm. And then the game, yeah, so you've got the code. Wow. I've never seen so many people arriving. Okay, lots of people are in. Yeah, even more people are in.
What a satisfying noise, isn't it, really?
That popping. Mm. Yeah. Okay, we've got 61 in. Oh, Helen's now in.
I had to be Helen in because there was always already a Helen. Is that you, Helen Stokes?
Okay. Oh, more pops. Okay. So Laura's in. Diane, Laura. Okay, I think you can join after the quiz has started. So we're going to start it now.
This is really good, Ceri.
I love the fact that Laura and Adam are on the top. Oh, people are catching up with you. Oh, Laura and Adam, you've been pipped to the post. Good. Okay, so most of you have finished. We'll wait a couple of seconds for a couple of people to get in. We're not going to be able to wait for everybody, unfortunately. Some people haven't answered any questions yet, so I'm going to remove some people from the bottom of the game. Please don't go in and start again.
I can see Laura and Adam know you well.
They have. Tash also got all her answers right, I think. Number 10, so she knows me quite well. So. Yes, understands my type of question. Okay, I'm going to end the game now. So we're on a couple of things for you to note. So you can see at the top the accuracy. And from lesson to lesson, I make a note. I sometimes reuse the same quiz, things like verbs in year 9, past, present, and future. And then I make a note, and then I give them a target for accuracy for this lesson as well. Or sometimes I give them the quiz at the beginning, at the end of the lesson, and then we compare the scores, and they have to, you know, to go to lunch early, they have to pass a particular accuracy point, and it really makes them concentrate. So you can see the green is how many correct answers and 732 and how many incorrect. It also gives you an idea. And then the questions, you can see the multiple choice. You can see here how many people had it correct and how many had them incorrect. It's been a busy day. So, and you should have worked out that that's my kitchen table with all those chocolate bars on it. And then not many people, unsurprisingly, know who the first minister in Wales is, and people are starting to get their heads around devolution for the first time, the fact that we can do different things from other people. And then you can see the different types of questions. So I've tried to put in the explanation for every question, what sort of a question it is. So then you're able to then to see how maybe that would be able to be used. Right, so I'm going to end the game now. So this is quite exciting. End game. So Laura and Adam came third, Anna second, and Girl came first. So congratulations, many congratulations. And then you have this data for different people that dance across the screen. And then you can see the accuracy was 73%. There's an option to play again, and then they'll show you the results then. And this is something I always go through with the class, the accuracy, which we know is 73. And then we look at the toughest question and we discuss maybe why it was the toughest question. So that was the gap fill. I think that was the Mark Drakeford question. And then the open-ended question is going to be the longest question, obviously, here, because it's a different type of question. But in class where you have every question, the same type of question, maybe that's why do they have to think about it longer? That's always a really valuable question. And then, interesting facts, two questions had an accuracy of less than 40%. So that's the point where you need to think, all right, I need to reteach this. I need to go over it again. And that's, from an assessment for learning point of view, was really, really handy. And then you can see then here how everybody did with the different questions. Okay, so you can see where the problems come. And obviously, we can see the question three has caused a lot of problems for lots of people. So that's just, so that's an overview, really, of the different types of questions in quizzes and how maybe you would be able to use it. Now, what's going to happen next? Need to think, how could you use this in school and also from home? So at the moment, obviously, we're teaching from afar. So how would you be able to use it in class? And also, how would you be able to employ this as distance learning at the moment? So in a second, Helen is going to press the magic button again to send you off to your breakout rooms. So once again, it's going to be for 2 minutes. I've got the timer this time. So, hi, I'm so-and-so. I come from so-and-so, and then 2 minutes, and then we'll call you straight back in then. So, Helen, are you okay? Hello, Helen?
Just to say, I believe I have recreated them, so you should be with different people. I'll be interested to know whether or not I have succeeded in that. Now, would you like me? I could just move you automatically there, and then that means that you don't have to click on join. Shall I do that, Ceri?
And then you could do that, see how that works. So it'd be interesting.
Let's see how that works, yes.
So the question is, how could you use Quizit in school and at home at the moment? Okay, so 2 minutes starting now.
Oh. Could I just ask, the people who are here, Natalie, Sylvie, Anna and Hamid, are you trying to get somewhere and you can't get there? You can open your and let me know.
I was in a breakout room, but I was the only person in it. So I came back to the meeting.
Okay, so I can actually, that this is quite helpful for me to know that, because then I think I can, so that was Anna, yes?
Yes.
So let's see if I can find you and then, but why are you not on there at the moment? Because it should be that I can then find you and then make you join another one. But I don't know, if you've got so many people, that's where...
Yeah, so, and it's fine, don't worry. It's no problem. It's just
from my point of view, I'd quite like to know how to do it. So, for example, in room 6, there's only one person.
And I didn't realise you could automatically join the breakout rooms. Previously, I've always been asked to join them, so that was interesting.
Yeah. I thought it just might sort of move things on a little bit if people weren't sure how to do it. But we've got some other people who are on their own. So is that Sylvie Parrish there from Breakout Room 46? Who might have come back because there's somebody else. In fact, what I'll do next time is I won't make as many rooms, and then it's more like there'll be somebody else there. So instead of going for 50 rooms, if we went for 40 rooms, that'd be all right, wouldn't it?
Yes.
Just to see how it's worked, I'm now going to make you join break room 1, see if it works.
Okay.
Okay, is that all right? Did you get an invitation? Okay. And then Natalie, Sylvie, Gozia, what's your situation? Would you mind telling me? So who's Sylvie saying it's not working for you? Sylvie, I don't see what your second name is. So Sylvie BR, right. You just be patient with me as I... In fact, I'll probably bring everybody back now and then we'll sort it out next time, okay? So I'll close all rooms. So apologies. I suppose what we can always do is anybody who doesn't get to a breakout room, we just say, well, let's make this the breakout room.
Hello.
You're coming back, I'd be quite interested to know, did things work? Were you able to speak to each other? Because some people were saying they couldn't hear each other.
No.
Could nobody speak?
Yeah, I went and there was a lady there, I spoke to her straight away. Right. But also Becky Stevenson was there and for some reason her video was off. I didn't quite understand that, but then... I clicked on the 3 dots in the top right and it gave me an option. If I do it to yours now,
right.
Something to do. And then I did that and then suddenly she appeared. So, yeah.
I think it might have been, because I was turning off videos for some people. I think they then can't turn the videos on if I'm co-host.
That's it, isn't it?
That's what's happened.
So I don't know whether we can override that before the next session.
Say that again, Joe.
If I can just say thank you ever so much for your understanding, everybody. I can see that for some of it worked, but also there were some people who said it worked better when they were allowed to join themselves. So I think next time we'll see how that works. And also, Ceri, I didn't mean to send you out to a breakout room, so I don't know how last time you had the choice, didn't you? So
no, it didn't send me at all, but it was lovely.
Yes. So if I can just say, I'll make it so it's not quite so many rooms for people who they were only meant to be 2 and 1 person didn't turn up. That won't happen again. Okay, thank you.
Excellent. So, I'm still sharing my screen, am I? Right, can you see my screen, Helen?
Sorry, no, you're not.
Am I sharing my screen? No,
you're not. So we start it. And I think it also sort of automatically cancels everything when you go out.
Okie dokie. So, if we go back to that. So, you know what's coming next. If we could go back to the chat and think, how could we use it in school and at home? So if you could type in the chat what you've just been discussing, and that would be really good for us to be able to share that.
And if you could now mute yourselves. You can hear people furiously typing away, which is great.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so lots of different ideas there. End of lesson recap, starters, analysis of questions, looking at progress, vocabulary testing, quick revision and some fun. So spelling, grammar checking, exit ticket, comprehension revision, plenaries. So lots of ideas there about, you know, at the beginning, at the end of lessons. Lots of people seem to be thinking that maybe that's a good thing. Consolidating tenses, time markers, revision work. And then somebody saying here, it's nice, there's a variety of different types of questions and the feedback element is good. So I would really agree with that. So I'm aware that it's already 3 minutes past nine.
Don't worry at all, because I rabbited on until 20 past nine and we had the cap. So really, we have said to people, if you need to go, that's fine. But as long as you're all right, Ceri.
Yeah, I'm fine. I've got no, funnily enough, I'm not going out. Okay. So I'm going to share my screen again. So thanks very much for the comments there. Maybe Helen and Joe, you could keep an eye on those. Maybe we pick up some matters at the end. Okay, so we've looked at quizzes. Okay, the other next thing I want to show you is questions in Google Classroom. I'm not sure if you're aware, because I just go to new assignments, bang, 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 and off you go. But when you click on create in your Google Classroom, in the classwork, there's the create, which is the create, and there's an assignment, which is the top option, which you go for. But the third one down is a question. And that's something I've started using during the lockdown, which has gone quite well. So for example, we've started our virtual sixth form. It started, a week last Monday. So my year 11 pupils want to continue with A level. I just asked them, Wie geht's, how are you? As a question, set it as a question, and everybody can answer. And then I then responded and then asked them another question. It's just to keep them ticking over, to thinking in the language, also writing the language, thinking about their accuracy, thinking about their spelling and things. So this is the conversation between me and one pupil. Another question I posted was, Was hast du letzte Woche gemacht? What did you do last week? Because I wanted just them to tick over thinking about their past tense verbs. And these are the responses from three people. Those boxes are to blank out their names. So, you know, it's not perfect, but then, you know, I will then think of the teaching and learning points that will come out from what they have written. Okay, so that's the question in Google Classroom. So it's, you know, it's not interactive like quizzes is, but, you know, there is interaction there between the staff member and the pupil. Okay. In our school, I think the main thing that people have enjoyed exploring over the lockdown is Google Forms. Now, we had used it before, and we had used it quite a lot before, but maybe we hadn't really explored all the possibilities, and lots of different departments have really gone to town on Google Forms this time. So, in the top right-hand side, you can see a link. It's here. It says, Newydd, new. Okay, and then it comes down, you need to go to Mwy, which is more, and then across, and then there are lots of options here, because also with Google Drive, I find with my colleagues, some of them just go to the docs, the sheets and the slides, they don't go any further. But if you go on Mwy, there are lots of other options that are really good. I know Joe's been doing some work on Jamboard. If you look that up on Twitter, lots of really good ideas coming through. Google Safleoedd, Google Sites, which is amazing. We've created so many sites in our school over the last maybe 3 or 4 years. We've got a site for everything, basically. And over the lockdown, they've really come in handy. And then here are the forms. So this is where you find them, the Google forms. So this is a form that we've been using today. There was a focus task for year seven in German today, and then in the forms it gives you really good feedback. So it gives us the marks, so this is how they did. It was out of 20, and then there was an extra section out of 5, so they're to go up to 25 if they wanted to go to do more complicated verbs. So it gives you sort of the median and the average and things at the top. And then it will tell you the questions that were wrong frequently. So it looks as if 38 children did that extra gold section, and some of them obviously had problems with those more difficult questions. But to be fair, they're year seven. We've prepared a series of lessons on the past tense, and they've had to teach themselves from home over the last week. So I got a brilliant colleague called Catherine, and Catherine has created these amazing resources one after the other. We'll show them in a second, different things to present the past tense over the last week. And then today they were tested on that, not tested, but they were given a quiz so we could see how much of it they understood. Feedback, we can see which classes. So you can see nearly half the year, the responses have come just from two classes. That's something that we can then feed back to the head of year to see what's happening in some of the other classes. This is the situation mid-afternoon, really, because it was the task for today. And you can see the feedback here of how many questions they're getting right. So the question was, choose the sentence that is in the past tense. And then obviously one of them only is in the past tense there. And also, I have been reading in my bedroom. And then obviously only one of those was right. So just different types of things really to ensure that the children read really thoroughly and go after the nitty gritty and the detail. Because obviously if you want to prepare them for GCSE later on, the detail in the reading exam is really there to catch them out. Okay, so this is a note for me, dangos a Google form. So if I come out of here, just want you to see really, this is the focus task we did on the 1st of May. Now, the biggest thing you have to remember with Google Forms is the first question has to be name and the second question has to be class. Because if you don't ask their name, you have 119 forms coming in here and you have no idea who's filled them in. So that is really, really, really important with Google Forms. You have to write that as a question. And then you can see here, Catherine embedded a video in here. She created the video on Spark Video, and then it's explaining different things about free time, and then all the questions then are based on the video. So this is how you can set listening work really as homework, and also as distance learning, because obviously that is quite difficult. So you can embed a video within the Google Form. So that's one thing we have done. That was the focus task on the 1st of May. And then this is today. So there's more children have done the quiz. So you can see here, this is the feedback that we have had. And these would be the questions then. Once again, name and then class being the top questions. This is something that the maths department has done, also embedded videos in. This is just thanking them for their work over the half term. And then the rest of the questionnaire is about, is the work being too hard, too long? What parts of the work have they really enjoyed? So the maths department is giving, that's going out tomorrow on the year seven site. Right then. So that's Google Forms. Now, if you go back to the front page, I'll go zoom down here. So this room that I've created, you can see here there are two clipboards with the Google Forms logo on them. Now, Joe, I hope you don't mind. Joe has circulated two examples of Google Forms showing the different types of questions that you can use. And I've created a copy for this evening. It's called Tilt Copy, and I've pasted them there. So in Google Slides, you need to be in the presentation mode, and then if you click on these, they will take you straight then to the different links. So I don't think there's any point in me explaining more about the different types of question. You've seen the sort of thing happening in quizzes, because Joe's presentations are so good that you just follow those and it'll give you an idea of the different type of questions you can use. But as I said, you have to go into presentation mode, and it goes straight to the slide. And then if you click on that, it will take you straight to where you want to be. So far, this is the Mentimeter that we've had, the quizzes we've looked at, this is my Twitter account, and these are the two Google Forms. And this will take you, this is the QR code to take you to this slide. And then some of the other pictures are yet to come. Right, fine. So if we now go down here, we're going to look at Quizlet. So for me, it is still the grandfather, really, of all quizzes. It is the thing that we fall back on mostly in the department. I've created over 600 Quizlet files now. It is my default. Everything goes through Quizlet. So if you go to Quizlet, there are lots of resources there for teachers and school leaders now. So that's sort of a thing on the Quizlet website now. Lots of things that have been curated and created by other people. And they also sell content now on Quizlet. But I've been using Quizlet since 2008. So it's a bit late now for me to buy somebody else's content. I got nearly everything I need. Fine. So in Quizlet, it's brilliant because you can have flashcards. You can use them on the board in class. And the children can flick through the flashcards and flip them over. So Tonya Antoniazzi, former head of MFL, is MP4A. You click on that, flip over, and it'll give you the answer. There's a learn mode. There's a write where they have to be able to spell everything. There's a spell where they listen, and then they type, and then they can generate a test. There's a match where you have to match the definition and the word itself, meaning the definition. You know what I mean, the word and the clue type of thing. Match those up. Gravity is really stressful because it goes against the clock and it goes really quickly. And then obviously Quizlet Live. So these are the different options, and also the amazing printing facility. Don't forget, when you're in school, if you want to create cards and matching cards up, or if you want to print a list for your pupils, then you can print them all off Quizlet. So there's no need to type them separately into Word. Just use it there. If you have a teacher account, and the teacher account is free at the moment, if you find a magic code from somebody, then you can get all the feedback as well. So I thought we would have a little game of Quizlet. So if I click on here, that takes me straight to where I want to be. So if we go to live, here goes, create game. Now, people who went to ILLIP 6, 7, I can't remember, I did a session in interactive quizzing. It's based on that. It's the questions are mainly politics. So sorry if you're not quite into politics. Some of the questions are dated so badly because so much has happened in politics since then. So I'm going to put you to compete as individuals because you're all in different places. And we want the answers like this. So we're going to select that option. Here we go. No, right, okay. So on your device, so you can either now scan the QR code, which is there, which will take you straight in, or you go to quizlet.live, and that is the code. And so obviously some people are very familiar and they're in already. So that is the code, 548888. I quite often, especially with the year 8 bottom set, I hide the screen and then I give them the number in German, and then they have to listen, and then it's forced them very quickly to learn the numbers. I do it for Quizlet and for Gymkit. So here we go. Is everybody in that wants to be in? 42 players. Not sure what the max is with Quizlet. I think we're probably about to find out. So maybe that code needs to be up a little bit. So as I said, yeah, I think the answers are all place names because I rewrote them this afternoon, and that seems to be a long time ago now. Okay, 60, 61, any more? In class, obviously, you can see who else wants to come in. So at home, obviously, the children can do all of the separate things, like look at the flashcards, do the match, do the rights, you know, that's not in real time, and they don't need to be online at the same time, because it seems to be in Wales, people are doing asynchronous teaching. We're not teaching live at all. the advice we've had about Zoom and things, and then Google Meet is blocked through Hub for children in Wales. You can teach live through Microsoft Teams, but I don't think many schools are doing that. And, you know, it just gives the children the flexibility really of being online when they want to be and when they can be and when it's suitable, because, you know, families sharing a computer and things, you know, is really unfair in lots of situations to ask them to be online at the same time. Right, okay, here we go. Cross your fingers, everybody. Un, dau, tri, bant a ni. And we're off. Oh, Ali, you're disconnected. Ali, can you sort that out? Tanya's also, right. Right. Oh dear, right, stop him anyway. So you can still join, the code is still on the top. And that. I'm going to take some photos now. How exciting! Let us see how many people are down here. Whoa! Yeah, not enjoying the politics question. The orcas are doing very well, whoever the orcas are. Seven. And the camels. And the oxen. And the zebras. Ooh, and the pandas. And the Tyrannosaurus rexes. Looks as if we're going to have a winner very soon. Well, oh, Tash, da iawn, Tasha. Excellent, gwych. So we can go to the stats. And then it gives you ideas here then about, we put the music off, ideas about what needs to be revised, gives you ideas of what pupils have mixed up. Okay. Yeah, it gives you an idea. So obviously in a class, if these were adjectives or verbs or connectives, it would be meaningful, but obviously these being mixed up are slightly strange. Okay, I'm going to exit that game. So I'm just going to show you a couple of things on Quizlet, because I'm sure most of you are familiar with these options here. Where people don't go and play around is here. So the three dots are the place to be, really. The three dots. Customize. It shouldn't be called customize, it should be called nick. Pinch the file. So click on customize, it makes a copy of somebody else's file, and then you can rename it as your own and pass it off as your own work. It's the saviour of many people, I'm sure. Obviously in Wales, teaching to the medium of Welsh, it's not really much use as a button, but we can always translate. The scores give you an overview of the scores. Now then the print. Now, print, look at this. You can have all the things in the file, all the vocabulary as a table or as a glossary or as small cards and large cards. A6 index cards, I think, are a waste of time because you're not going to print them on those. But these options, table, glossary, small, large, and I print lots of these out on card, laminate them, cut them with a guillotine, and then I have sets of cards then for all sorts of things. You can put them in alphabetical order, or you can put them in the order that they were, or you can flip them also, so you can have the questions and then the answers differently. Okay, you open it as a PDF and you print it out. It is a real lifesaver. So quite often we create booklets, we work from booklets at school. So very often I will print them out and put them in the booklet. And then on the top then of the page, I will put a QR code so then the children can, as well as read the Quizlet list, they can also go through it like that. Okay, so those are all, most of the things I wanted to tell you here. progress. This is the edit button. You can share here. But the three dots, I think, is where all the where the fun is. Okay, so that's Quizlet. I'm sure you're quite familiar with most of that. Right, so GymKit is the next thing. Now, GymKit is sort of a naughty cousin, really, of Quizlet, because you can use the content from Quizlet and just copy it straight into GymKit. It's really handy. It's really easy to create. Now, I think the limit on GymKit is you can create five, what they call it, kits, which is five quizzes, and after that you have to pay. So I have paid. I teach Year 8 bottom set. It's worth every penny. They absolutely love it. So we're going to look at GymKit. You can create an assignment. So I've created it in, you know, the deadline is 40 years, 30 years. I'm quite confident I'm not still going to be teaching at that point. And then it's like Quizlet. Catherine said at one point, I think it's like Quizlet crossed with Monopoly. So it really is that, where the children have to earn some money. So if we go over to Quizlet, one thing on it is a kit collaboration where the pupils can come up with their own questions, and then you as a teacher can accept or reject those questions that they come up with, and then you can play their questions, which is a really good thing. So maybe we'll have a go at that, because I think people are familiar now with GymKit, but maybe not the fancy parts of it. So if we go over to GymKit, where have we got to here? GymKit. Okay. So if I continue with this, you can see here. Well, no, actually, maybe not. This I've imported all those questions from Quizlet, all the politics questions into this. So probably you don't want to do that, the same thing again. So if you go back to my dashboard, if you click on kit collaboration, maybe we'll do one of these. Okay, so this is where you will be creating the kit. So if I call it tilt live, oopsie-daisy, can't type. It's going to be in English probably, world languages, next. The really annoying thing is you have to choose a photo. So we go for the palm trees today. And then if we go for the classic, there's a new option here. There's often some different options, and the children really enjoy the variety. Okay, if we just do 2 minutes and continue. So here now, if you go to gymkit.com/play, and that's the number, then you can create your own questions. Okay, and they'll appear on the right-hand side. So well done, Vic. So you would have a point in class charts from me for being the first person to sign in. That's something also I often do in class, especially with lower sets. I'll give the first child to sign in a point on class charts, because it is the best way of getting them all in really, really quickly. There's a bit of urgency about the whole thing then. And then I'm not sure if you can add questions straight away. Are you able to add your questions there?
Yes, it's coming up. Is that add your question to be used during the name?
Oh, loads of people. It's another photo to take, I think. And I treat. Yeah, excellent. Right. So I don't speak Spanish, so I'll add the question. Yeah, lovely. Add. So enjoying this. Yeah, excellent. Depends how big the book is, of course. And capital of Spain. And oh, I think we've had this question already. Language spoken in Brazil, so we're going to reject that. Because I'll add it. I'll have the same question. Excellent. Yeah, good question. What day is it today? Chili. Chocolate. Oh dear. Right. Oh, that's a good question. Where is the best university in Wales? Oh, Lampeter, interesting. I went to Swansea myself, but there we are. Where do you live? Sarah T lives in the Wirral, so just remember that. French president, Schmetterling, excellent. Oh yeah, we love that. Guten Morgen. So I think everybody who's given me a question is now green. And oh, this is Tasha's question. We did last training in Pembrokeshire. Excellent. Oh, lots of German questions. I know lots of friends from the Teaching German Facebook group are here tonight, so shout out to you as well. Thanks for joining us. Okay, dear me. Right, wow. Excellent. Right, okay, so we'll start the game now because, and then you can play your own questions. So I put the timer on for 2 minutes because that's plenty of time this evening. And this is going to be really interesting. So Christina's taken the lead. Well done, Christina. Oh, Lucy's taken the lead. Oh, Dawn has found the upgrade. Well done, Dawn. Oh, there's a Laura and Adam. Laura and Adam obviously understand the upgrading money, level 2. Diane Kathleen, my former pupil Kathleen, has also upgraded her money to level 2. And we're halfway there, so there's 1 minute gone and there's 1 minute to go. Amanda's at the lead at the moment, and Zoe, Kate, Tina, well done. And we've got 25 seconds to go, and then we'll be finishing. Put the music back on. There we are. Well done, Amanda, wherever you are. So clap for Amanda. You can clap on the right-hand side. You can see there the numbers going up. So you can see, and these are people's final scores. Some people still entering their names. That's quite sad. There we are. Better luck next time. So this is that's how gym kit, or as Joe Dale calls it, gym kit. Like that in our school, we call it gym kit. So this is how it works. So I think with pupils creating their own questions, that's really handy. It's a really valuable tool. And maybe you can add some ideas in the chat. I'm not going to send you out to a room now to discuss that a minute. So that's the kids collaboration, and then you've obviously seen how a game works. So the timings. If you put them to the end of your teaching career, then the game is going to be live for the whole time. With the sums of money, we did have a complaint from some year 7 parents at the beginning of the lockdown that they needed to earn £5 million or something to finish the game, which took some children all day. We've gone in school 300,000 for bronze and silver challenges and 500,000 for gold pupils. So the children at the moment are choosing their levels and they are going with that. So that gives them, you know, enough time really to go over the vocabulary and revisit it. And, you know, they are learning things like adjectives, verbs, some nouns for the topics that we've been doing. So that's been, it's been really handy. Okay, so we've played some gym kit. So Kahoot, I'm sure you're mostly familiar with Kahoot. So again, it's a real favourite. You know, the kids in the black row all stand on their feet so they can see all the questions properly. You have really good feedback from Kahoot. If you set it as a challenge, you can have the percentage. I was dismayed by the 58%. Also, it gives you the difficult questions. And it sort of highlights those for you. And then it gives you a list of children who need help as well with the lowest scores, and also tells you which pupils didn't manage to finish the game. So that's really, really handy to give you a quick overview of progress. And then here you have a sort of question by question summary here. These are the little words, you know, zealout, sulout, echtlout, the subtle differences really that will catch them out later on in at GCSE level. So those are sort of ideas of Kahoot. Now, at the moment, there are two options on Kahoot. I think this is new. So one is them for virtual classrooms and one of them is for self-paced learning. So if we're going to play a quick game of Kahoot, so you need to go to kahoot.it. That is the site there. And if I go into Kahoot here, where are we? Kahoot. This thing is in the way. Kahoot. Oh, right. Kahoot is here. Right. I don't want to share. I don't want to. Right. There we are. Play now. So if I go on play now. So we want to do play live. This is the one we want. Now we're going to go for the classic option. And here we go. And we are waiting. And the really good thing is that you can put a song or a film in while you're waiting for everybody to sign in, so they can even do some listening exercises.
Dann bin ich super drauf. Und ich flieg wie ein Flieger, bin so stark wie ein Tiger und so groß wie eine Giraffe, so groß.
So, some of you who have been to Dorking to the conferences will be familiar with the Fliegerlied, as will every self-respecting German teacher. It is the ultimate annoying song for any pupils of any age. Okay, so people are still coming in. 68 of you in the game at the moment. 69, 17. Excellent. Give another 5 seconds. Okie dokie. So, here we go. What is English in German? Be careful. So I put 20 seconds on the timer, so you can change the timings according to how difficult the questions are and how much they need to read, really. That's the crunch. There we are. Well done. So English with S-C-H at the end. Okay, I'm not sure who that soaring egret is, or the groovy octopus. Excellent. Okay, it's the second question. What is Welsh in French? There we are, so we've been timed out again by the 20-second rule. So once again, you know, checking vocabulary, checking understanding, or obviously with the first question, that's checking the subtlety of spelling. And then you can see the scores changing. Only 4 questions here because, you know, you get the drift. Watch the capitalization, please. Ooh, straight in there. Thank you. excellent. So in German, nouns need capital letters, that's Musik with a capital M. And the children really kick themselves when they get things like that wrong, and they never get it wrong again. So it can have a really positive effect on their writing and the accuracy of their writing as a result of things like this. And then space dolphin ones, another sturdy giraffe taking over from this groovy octopus. And the last question, what is English in Welsh? Excellent. So the red option, Saesness, is an English lady. Saeson is the plural, English people. Saesneg is English, the language. And Saes is an Englishman. Actually, you've learnt something this evening. And then there's a podium. Really exciting. So I'm not sure who the charming cat is. And then the groovy octopus is second. But the prize this evening goes to the space dolphin. So well done you. Maybe you can tell us in the chat who you are, and then you can see who the runners up are. And there's a little bit of dance there, so the children obviously really enjoy that at the end of the game. The feedback is quite handy. You can have a look at the results, you can download the results and look at the report. So you can, on the report, once again, you can see the accuracy, 74%, well done team. And then you can see here, they were not any questions that were particularly difficult, then some people needed some help, and then here are the people who didn't finish. So then this is a sort of a good summary really of what's gone on during the game. It's really handy. So that's Kahoot. But one thing before I go on, before I forget, with Google Forms, if you want to set a quiz in Google Forms where the marks are automatically exported into your Google Classroom mark sheet, which means it's really handy because you don't even need to mark. If you're clever enough to create a quiz that there's only one option and it is either right or wrong, if you ask the children to write something, it's going to be more difficult. You're going to have to go and check spellings and things. Or if you're only going to accept one spelling, or if you're going to accept capitalization and things, that makes things more complicated. If you create a quiz where there's only correct answers and that it is really straightforward, then you can export all the marks. The children get the mark then straight away, and you need to go into the settings there. So I'm not sure if somebody wants to hear about that, especially if you're teaching in Wales and you're doing it through Hub, there are certain things that you have to click on the quiz in order for it to carry the marks through. So if we go here, you go to this wheel. And here, you, in order to get the marks into your mark sheet, you have to click collect email addresses. Whatever this option, the next option is, you need to do that. That accept something, responses, I don't know what it's called on the English version. Then you have to click on every time. Then here in Wales, you have to put it limited to users in Hub. And then also you have to, everybody, Hub or not, limit the pupils to one answer only, okay, and then that will carry it through. With that, this doesn't matter there. And then here, quizzes, you have to make it a quiz, and then you can release the grades either straight after or later after you've had a chance to review the work. Okay, so that's Kahoot, and I'm coming to an end. I'm sure you're really, really pleased. I did have another question for a breakout room, but I'm aware that it's really late now. So bringing everything together is how I'm going to finish my presentation. So this is what we do in school. This is what we've done maybe over the lockdown. So maybe this is the thing that's going to be most interesting for people at the moment. So Google Sites. We give the links to all the different quizzes on Google Sites. Now this week, the pupils have done this work on the past tense. So we presented them with a Spark page presenting this past tense, a Spark video where Catherine explained the past tense, and then Catherine created the quizzes which was ich habe verbs. Then she did a special quizzes, including the ich bin verbs for the movement. They would be the equivalent of the être verbs in French. And then they, on one day, they just had quiz, gym kit files just to practice over and over with the different targets. And then after they'd done those different activities on different days, then they did the assessment today. So that's the lead-in. And those are all the links in the same place on Google Sites. We're a Welsh medium school. Lots of the parents don't speak Welsh. So this is the guidance then for parents. So that's one thing. That's how it looks on our Google Sites. This is a close-up here of the parental guidance, because it's in English, for my year 8 bottom set. These are the tasks. This is how I set it out in my Google Classroom, the different activities that they've had to do there, because we have to sort of set work for 53 minutes, which is a lesson. And then this is how the links look when they appear on Google Classroom. So we'll just post the links in. Catherine has done some jigsaws for them on different topics. So there's an easy jigsaw and a difficult jigsaw with different amounts of pieces. And there's vocabulary all over the jigsaw. So as well as matching up the colours, they are bringing the words together. And then there's a quick gym kit and a quizzes for them to do then. And what they do when they finish, they do some screenshots, and then they send the screenshots back. And this is a pupil, and then I sent him a message, and then he sends me a message back saying, iawn, diolch, fine, thank you. And then this is another pupil, once again, showing how much money they've made on gym kit, and then pictures of the jigsaws, and then a picture of his score on quizzes. Okay, so then as a result, I put them the marks then on class charts. So this is the room again. Well, that's the earlier version of the room. So, you know, that's it now. Any questions? I'm sure some of you are desperate to go to bed. Pass back to Helen. So thank you very much, everybody, for coming. I hope it's been useful for you. And then you know how to get hold of me. You can get hold of me through Twitter, or we can have a chat now on the chat, or if somebody has got some questions, you can stay and we can discuss them face to face on the Zoom.
Well, Ceri,
diolch yn fawr iawn, thank you very much.
That was absolutely brilliant. In true Tilt fashion, could, if you wouldn't mind unsharing your screen, and then if everybody could open up their videos, their audios, we're going to give you a massive round of applause, say thank you. I'm going to take some pictures, and then we'll decide on... So, everybody, really, really well done. While you're doing that, I'm going to take some pictures of you. Here's the first. Just three now, 1, 2, 3. So keep going. And the next one, 1, 2, 3. Lovely. Thank you very much indeed. That's great. We've got some pictures. That was absolutely amazing. You will really enjoy, I'll say this to all the speakers, you will really enjoy seeing the lovely feedback there. So interactive, people getting involved, lots of people, thank you. If anybody wants to actually say thank you now, feel free to open your mic and say it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. It was amazing.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Fabulous.
Thank you.
That's lovely.
Hello. Somebody's speaking Welsh to me. I don't know who that is, though. Hello, pwy sy'n iawn?
Natasha.
Hiya, Tash. Ti'n iawn?
Fi'n iawn. Anhygoel. Amazing.
Oh, diolch i ti. Na i siarad y ti cyn bo hir, ia?
Ie, wrth gwrs.
Nos da.
That's lovely. Thank you ever so much for joining in.
Thank you very much.
You have worked so hard. I would say probably, I mean, there'll be questions, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. Some of the questions I expect we could answer in writing, actually, at some point. So perhaps if people have got
pressing questions, I would rather answer them now, because I don't really foresee I'm going to have time to go through.
No, not for you. I was thinking we might be able to look at it, but anyway. But no. Yes. So, should we say 10 minutes, Joe? For
yeah, any that's questions? Fine. I've been working incredibly hard all evening, answering all the questions I possibly could. I think we've got about 5 questions which I couldn't answer there and then, but all the other questions, people have been bombarding the chat with questions, which has been great, and I've tried my very best. Sometimes I do think, like, saying, well, there's this thing called Google, you could just Google it. But anyway, I would never be so rude as to say that, but But yeah, like, for example, I've never been asked the question, what does Kahoot mean? I don't know. So I was just Googling.
Because I've never thought of it and I found the answer now. So thank you. That's
great. Anyway, right. So should we go through the questions? Is that all right? That was a great job, Ceri. I was sort of half watching and then looking at the chat with my other eye. So let's go on to the questions, which I've got here.
So now we're
Right. Four questions. Right. Okay. So, right. For quizzes, when the quiz is live, is there a time limit for each question? Is the assignment... Oh, yeah, so that was the... Right, so first question. In quizzes, when the quiz is live, mm-hmm. is there a time limit for each question?
No, because I put it on the mode where it's self-paced. I think that's what you do. So if we go to... Hang on a sec. Where are we going? Quizzes. Okay, if I exit that, they need my help. They can go away. Right, my quizzes, tilt. So if I set it up, play live, classic. Right, so there's student attempts, which was on unlimited, name factory, which was off. Show answers in game, which was on. Show answers post game, which was also on. The power ups were on. The timer was on. So there was a countdown timer for each question. There's a leaderboard. You can shuffle the questions. You can shuffle the answers. You can have a redemption question. You should show memes. So I think you had some random memes after your question. I do have my own memes and I've forgotten to put those in. So you can go through the settings and ensure that you're happy. And there are also new advanced settings. So I would suggest that that people go through those and choose what best suits them. But obviously for the distance learning option, then obviously they're going to be doing it self-paced, aren't they?
Yeah, and you can also set the homework assignments, can't you?
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
So what's great about things like quizzes and Gymkit, they all have different options for participating asynchronously. So you've got the Kahoot challenges, Gymkit assignments, and quizzes homeworks, haven't you?
And obviously Quizlet will allow you to do anything from afar anyway. So
yeah, I posted a great long list of all the things you can do with those ones I've just mentioned in the chat as well. So let's go on to another question. I'm not exactly right. This is from Anne-Marie. I wasn't exactly sure why she was asking this question. I just said in the chat. Anyway, any chance I could run two differentiated quizzes simultaneously? So I'm not sure why she would want to do that, but that's the question.
I'm not sure what's happening here.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. Maybe people could turn their webcams off, maybe, because it's a bit distracting.
I put the mute on.
Okay, no problem.
No, don't switch your cameras off. We can't see.
Okay.
I would say, well, you would need either a different tab for each quiz,
yeah,
or you'd need two computers to run the two things simultaneously. Yeah. And obviously, if you're in your classroom, you can only see the feedback and the scores going up from one quiz at a time on your whiteboard in your class.
Yeah. So you could have a split screen, couldn't you? But I don't see why you'd have two quizzes running simultaneously.
Well, in a mixed ability class, maybe you would want to do that, but you would need to run them on different tabs, but only one set of kids would be able to see their progress going across the screen.
Yeah, okay. Mm. Thank you. Next question. This one I didn't know. How would you get a QR code for the Quizlet? Does it just appear?
Appear, yeah.
Right, so when you launch a set, the QR code is just there to scan, yeah?
Yeah, it does. It's been there for quite a while, but it hasn't always been there in Quizlet. But so the children, it's like 50-50. The ones who sit in the front of the class tend to scan it because they have a direct view of it. And then the ones further back will go, we've got the Quizlet app on the school iPads anyway. So the children all literally, their name is saved automatically. All they need to do is put the number in.
Okay, that's lovely. And last question, this is from Laura. She said, Ceri, when I've tried to print out the Quizlet as a quiz, it takes up so many pages. Any advice on that?
I've never had a problem with the printing. What, as a test, you mean, or what?
I'm not sure. I don't know if Laura's still in the room. Maybe Laura can clarify. You're muted, Helen.
No, Laura gave her apologies. She just had to leave, so we can know who Laura is. So
yeah, that's right. So I'm not sure if is it easy when you print off the quizzes as a printout to get everything so it's not
from Quizlet, yeah.
Yeah, I'm not sure. There were so many questions. I presume that she's talking about Quizlet, but I'm not sure, to be honest.
Quizlet turns them. You choose your view because the ones I clicked through, like the list and the different types of cards, and you choose your view and it turns it into a PDF. So it should be fine because a PDF is a really set size.
Okay, we can maybe ask Laura what she means on Twitter later. But yeah, that's it. That's all the questions. All the other ones I've answered already. So we've...
Brilliant. Thanks, Joe.
That's right. Florence has asked whether the chat's going to be saved, but we always put the chat on the AOL website, don't we, Helen?
Yes, that's right. So what I'll be doing, and that I can do straight away now, is that I go onto the website. I've got already a page which is dedicated to Ceri, and on it you'll have the link to the video when Joe publishes that, and then a link to the chat, and then I put up the pictures as well. So, because I think, you know, the way that you've run this, Ceri, has been really good in that there will be so many ideas which will come out from those breakout groups as well. I could see all of the, you know, lots and lots of ideas. So there'll be a lot to read.
Yeah. And then you can also put the link to the presentation if you want as well.
Oh, that would be great. Yes.
Yeah. So that people can click on the my virtual room.
Yeah. So if that's everything, I really do want to say, I always do say thank you so much to you, Ceri, but also Joe Dale, he's been the person.
Tonight's been full on, but I've loved it. Yeah, I love all the questions, but it's been really full on.
What are you expecting, Joe? Come on.
Yeah. Well, more than normal. It's been really full on with questions tonight, but it's lovely. 140 people we had in the room, so that's really awesome.
It is, and I love the way, because really what you're doing is that you're answering the questions, because we know that people often they really would like the answer then, and Joe, you're just giving that service in a way, just doing what you can there and answering the questions. So really, really well done. Really, that went so well. Thank you ever so much, everybody. And lovely to see all of these faces. I'm about to stop the recording, but really, in particular, Slinky, thank you very much for being there the whole way through, apparently. Alice Semple, so Slinky Semple, very nice to see you. So I think we need to bring a pet another time as well. Thank you ever so much. So I will now stop the recording. I'll stop the live stream and the recording. Stop the recording.